Hello student, this is Anthony Christy Melson, Department of Mathematics, BMS College of Engineering. In this lecture, I will be discussing about the solution of partial differential equations by separation of variables. Consider a PDE of the form f of x, y, u, ux, uy, uxx, uxy, uyy, and so on. This we will call it as equation 1. In the method of separation of variables, we assume u, which is a function of two independent variables x and y, to be of the form x capital X into capital Y, where capital X is a function of x and capital Y is a function of y. Now 2 implies ux is x dash into y, uxx is x double dash into y, and so on. Uxy, uy is xy dash, uxy is x dash y dash, u double y is xy double dash, and so on. Substituting 2 and these derivatives in 1 and separating them will result in a function of the form x and y are independent variables, and here we have functions of x and here we have functions of y. Since x and y are independent variables, this is possible only when this is equal to a constant. Therefore, we have f1 of x, x, x dash, x double dash, and so on equal to constant, which is equation 3. Then function of y, capital Y, and its derivatives equal to a constant, which is equation 4. Equations 3 and 4 have to be solved using one of the methods learned in first semester. Let us consider solve x squared dou u by dou x plus y squared dou u by dou y equal to 0 by separation of variables. So we assume u of xy as x into y, now 1 implies dou u by dou x equal to x dash into y, and dou u by dou y is x y dash. Two in PDE
will result in x squared x dash y plus y squared x y dash equal to 0. Now we need to separate small x, capital X dash and x from the variables y. So we divide by 1. So we get x squared x dash by x plus y squared y dash by y equal to 0, which simplifies to x squared x dash by x equal to minus y squared y dash by y. Now as we see, left hand side we have functions of small x and the right hand side we have functions of small y. Since x and y are independent, this can be equal only when they are equal to a constant k. So we have x squared x dash by x equal to constant which we'll call it as 3 and minus y squared y dash by y equal to constant which we'll call it as 4. Now equations 3 and 4 have to be solved. Three implies x square x dash equal to kx, that is x square dx by dx minus kx equal to 0, or now this is in the form of dx by x plus px equal to q. Here q equal to 0. The solution is x e power integral p dx equal to integral q e power integral p dx plus c1. Now e power integral p dx is e power integral minus k by x square dx, which is e power k by x. So x e power k by x equal to c1, or x equal to e power c1 e power k by x. Now similarly, 4 implies minus y squared y dash by y, this is equal to ky. So we have y squared dy by d small y plus ky equal to 0, or dy by y plus k by y squared y equal to 0. Now this is in the same form as the linear differential equation, where capital X is replaced by capital Y and small x is replaced by small y. So the solution will be y e power integral p dy equal to c2, since q equal to 0. So e power integral p dy will be e power integral k by y squared dy, which is e power minus k by y. So here this should be a minus here. So y e power minus k by y equal to c2, implies y equal to e power c 2 e power k by y. Since u of x y equal to x into y, u of x y will be c 1 e power minus k by x, c 2 e power k by y. That is a e power minus k by x plus k by y will be the solution.
Consider this example. Solve dou z by dou x equal to 2 times dou z by dou y plus z, subject to the condition z of x comma 0 equal to 6 e power minus 3x by separation of variables. Similar to the previous example, here z is a function of x and y. Therefore, we shall assume z to be of the form capital X into capital Y, where capital X is a function of X and capital Y is a function of small y. So this we will represent it as equation 1. So dou z by dou x equal to x dash into y, and dou z by dou y equal to x into y dash. Substituting 1 and 2 in the PDE, we get x dash into y equal to 2 into x y dash plus xy. Dividing throughout with respect with equation 1, we get x dash by x equal to 2 times y dash plus 1. Now here we find the variables capital X and capital Y are separated. Now this has to be equal to a constant K. So we have x dash by x equal to k, and 2 y dash by y plus 1 equal to k. So we need to solve x dash minus kx equal to 0 and 2y dash plus 1 minus k into y equal to 0. So we need to solve equation 3 and equation 4. Now 3 implies dx by dx minus kx equal to 0, which implies x into if equal to 0 plus c1. If, which is the integrating factor, is e power integral p dx, that is e power integral minus k dx, which will be e power minus kx. So x equal to x into e power minus kx equal to c1, or x equal to c1 e power kx. Similarly, 4 implies dy by y plus 1 minus k by 2 into y equal to 0, which implies y into integrating factor is equal to 0 plus c2. The integrating factor here will be e power integral p dy, which is e power integral 1 minus k by 2 into dy, which is e power 1 minus k into y by 2. So y into e power 1 minus k y by 2 equal to c2. So we have y equal to c2 e power k minus 1 y by 2. We need to substitute equation 5 and 6 in equation 1. So we have equation 5 and 6. 1 implies z equal to x into y. So we have c1 e power kx, c2 e power k minus 1 y by 2. So we have z equal to a e power kx e power k minus 1 y by 2, where a is c1 c2. If we recollect, the condition given is at x comma 0, z is 6 times e power minus 3x. So using this, we have 6 e power minus 3x equal to a e power kx. This equation is obtained by taking y equal to 0 in equation 7. So we have a equal to 6 and k equal to minus 3. Therefore, we have z of xy equal to 6 e power minus 3x into e power minus 2y. That is, k minus 1 by 2 is minus 2, which is the complete solution. Let us take another example dou squared z by dou x squared minus 2 dou z by dou x plus dou z by dou y equal to 0. Now z equal to function of xy, and hence we consider z to be of the form capital X into capital Y. So dou z by dou x will be x dash y, dou squared z by dou x squared will be x double dash y, and dou z by dou y will be x y dash. Substituting equation 1 and 2 in the PDE, we get x double dash y minus 2 times x dash y plus x y dash equal to 0. Dividing by equation 1, we get x double dash by x minus 2x dash by x plus y dash by y equal to 0. So we have x double dash by x minus 2x dash by x equal to minus y dash by y, which we take it to be constant k. So we have x double dash by x minus 2x dash by x equal to k, which reduces to x double dash minus 2x dash minus kx equal to 0. Minus y dash by y equal to k, which reduces to y dash plus ky equal to 0. We need to solve equation 3 and equation 4. We have equation 3 and 4 to be solved. Now 3 implies d squared x minus 2 dx minus kx equal to 0. Where d is d by dx, so we have d squared minus 2d minus k into x equal to 0. This is a second order differential equation. The solution x is the complementary function. Because the right hand side is 0, we have particular integral to be 0. So we need the auxiliary equation f of m equal to 0, where f is the differential operator d square minus 2d minus k. So we have m squared minus 2m minus k equal to 0. So m equal to 2 plus or minus square root of 4 plus 4k by 2, which is 1 plus or minus root 1 plus k. Now there are two possibilities here: k equal to minus 1 and k not equal to minus 1. if k equal to minus 1, then m equal to 1 comma 1, so x equal to c1 plus c2 x e power x. If k not equal to minus 1, then x equal to c1 e power 1 plus or minus root 1 plus k x plus c2 e power 1 minus root 1 plus k into x. Now, for k not equal to minus 1, depending on the value of k, either we get real roots for m or complex roots. Because of e power I theta equal to cos theta plus I sine theta, it is okay to write the solution x in this form. Now, y equal to and integrating factor is e power integral k dy, which is e power ky. So y e power ky equal to c3, so y equal to e power c3 e power minus ky. So z equal to x into y. Therefore, z equal to c1 plus c2x e power x into c3 e power y if k equal to minus 1, and z equal to c1 e power 1 plus root 1 plus k x plus c2 e power 1 minus root 1 plus k into x into c3 e power minus ky if k not equal to minus 1. So this would be the solution of the given PDE.